I'm here presenting SB1 to you all this morning. Thank you, Mr. Vice Chair. This is the second committee now we've been before, and the second year we've unfortunately had to carry this measure. And I say it's unfortunate because as a state, I don't think we want to be put in this position, but I think we've been forced to. Given the actions in Washington over 34 different clean air, water, endangered species, worker safety standards have been weakened or eliminated. Executive orders on everything from the Waters of the U.S. rule to Clean Water Act, Clean Air Act standards, importation of ivory, body parts of threatened species such as elephants and rhinos, as well as an executive order that was adopted to stop disclosing toxic hazards in the workplace that directly affects the health of workers. These are all actions coming out of Washington. So the premise of this bill is that we can't afford to go backwards. There is a lot of progress to be made when it comes to workplace safety, when it comes to tackling climate change, when it comes to cleaning up our oceans, our water, our air, our land, as we heard from numerous authors earlier. So progress remains, but we at least can't allow the federal government to undercut our state's plenary power to protect its health and safety to actually make sure our citizens can live here and afford to breathe here and drink the water here. And so we consider this a type of insurance policy that hopefully we won't have to exercise, but if necessary, this bill would authorize state agencies to step in and at least enforce the baseline standards that we left at the end of the Obama administration. We know the federal standards are often weak, even when it's a solid president who actually believes in science. But in this case, we're facing an administration and, frankly, a Congress that we feel is a risk. This is not intended to poke anyone in the eye back in D.C., and in fact, we wish we weren't in this fight in the first place. But here we are, and we're going to move forward and assert our plenary power and do what we have to do to protect our people. So with that, I would respectfully ask for your aye vote.